And so he tells us, I have installed my king on Zion, my holy hill. So his message is, here is the Lord Jesus Christ. Here is the Messiah King. He is what you need to focus on. He is your only hope, actually. I've installed my king. And then it says, I will proclaim the decree of the Lord. And this is the king speaking, the Messiah King. He said to me, you are my son. Today I have become your father. Ask of me, and I will make the nations your inheritance, the ends of the earth your possession. You will rule them with an iron scepter. You will dash them to pieces like pottery. Now that verse, dashing them to pieces like pottery, is used in Revelation for the day of judgment. So we might think this rebellion of the world, he would immediately come and smash this down like an iron bar smashing into a plate full of crockery, and it's all ruined and destroyed with no hope and no future. But the Bible tells us that he reserves for as long as he possibly can. That only happens on the final day of judgment. Rather, he's saying to us, look, he is the Father with his Son, and he delights in his Son. And his Son looks at the nations of the world, and he, instead of thinking, I don't care about them, I don't want anything to do with them, rather, ask of me, and I will make the nations your inheritance, the ends of the earth your possession. So this rebellious world that makes him angry, makes him upset,